This video introduces you to the new features in Thermo-Calc 2017B, which was released in October 2017. Thermo-Calc 2017B introduces the first ever CALPHAD thermodynamic database, which covers both titanium-based alloys and titanium-aluminum-based materials in a single database called TCTI1. TC-TI1 consists of 23 elements with 236 assessed binary systems and more than 70 assessed titanium-containing ternary systems. The database can also be employed to design light alloys based on the Al3Ti and AlTi3 intermetallic phases. Thermo-Calc 2017B also includes a new mobility titanium database, MOB-Ti2, which was developed to be used in conjunction with TC-TI1. A new thermodynamic database for noble and precious metal alloys is also available in this release, TC-Noble-1. This database is developed within a 21-element framework and can be applied to applications such as jewelry, decoration industries, and dental alloys, as well as delicate components for scientific equipment, such as thermocouples and calorimetry elements. Our thermodynamic database for aluminum alloys, TCAL5, has been expanded to include erbium, increasing this aluminum database to 35 elements. This update highlights the assessment of many binary and ternary systems relevant to the 8XXX and 8XX.X series of industrial aluminum alloys, including but not limited to those currently listed on the screen. In total, 258 binary and 87 ternary systems have been assessed. TCHEA2 has improved stability descriptions in the sigma phase in the 2017B release. Updates were also made to the substance database, S-sub-6. The Diffusion module DICTRA and the Precipitation module TC-PRISMA both received significant updates in this release. Both were updated so that up to 3 elements can be used without a license, meaning that all users can now run all of the included examples files. The Precipitation module received 2 major new features in the 2017B release, and 3 new examples accompany the release to help you learn about these features. A new calculation type has been added to the Precipitation module, Continuous Cooling Transformation, or CCT. This allows users to make a calculation which maintains the same cooling rate for the entire time. You simply set starting and ending temperatures and the different rates at which you would like it to cool. Example P7 highlights this feature and is accompanied by an instructional video. The second major feature added to the precipitation calculator is the ability to set the morphology of non-spherical particles to cuboid, plate, and needle. The evolution of the shape when the particles grow is determined by competition between interfacial energy and elastic strain energy. You can learn about the theory behind these settings in the online help system. Search for morphology, then select precipitation morphology. You can also refer to the new examples included in your software, P8 and P9, and to the video for example P9, to learn more about the new morphology settings. The additional features in the precipitation module have been added behind Show Details buttons, so the program is still easy to use for those who do not require the additional options. The Diffusion module DICTRA also received several new features in the 2017B release, and 3 new Diffusion examples have been added to this release to explain the new features. It is now possible to set boundary conditions, which allows users to fix the activity or composition for each boundary. Refer to example D7 and watch the accompanying video to learn more about boundary conditions. Composition profiles are now visualized directly when you enter them. A useful tooltip explains how each one works and how to set them. User-defined functions can now be used when defining initial composition profiles, and the profiles are visualized when entering them, allowing you to see if there are any mistakes before you start the simulation. For example, we can enter a smooth step function using the error function ERF. All regions are now visible in the configuration window of the diffusion module. Small regions that would be too small to see are now represented with a dashed line. A tooltip appears when you hover over a region, which shows the name of the region, the width of the region, and the number of grid points. A new advanced mode option gives users more control over the plots in the diffusion module and allows you to plot additional combinations, such as activity at a specific time. You can now also plot user-defined functions using Thermo-Calc console mode syntax, giving you a lot of flexibility in the plotting. For example, you can plot the position of the upper side of the ferrite region in the power of 2. A table renderer has also been added to the diffusion module for tabulation of simulation results. To see these new features in action, watch the new example video D7 Diffusion Carburization Multiphase. Thermo-Calc 2017B adds 3D plotting for grid calculations in the Property Model Calculator and the Equilibrium Calculator. To see your results in 3D, set up either an equilibrium calculation or a property model calculation, then select 3D from the plot type menu in the plot configuration window. Users can view multiple surfaces by defining several axes. Click on the plot and move the mouse to rotate the image, giving you a full view of the results, or double-click on the plot to rotate the image automatically. Example T11 has been updated to include a 3D plot comparing the coarsening rate coefficient using the property model calculator. The Scheil calculator has been updated to be faster and more reliable. The improved Scheil calculator has better handling of multiple composition sets and no longer resets if a new composition set is found, and it automatically changes numerical settings if needed. This release also includes several updates that improve the usability of the software. To learn about these and all of the new features, updates, and databases in Thermo-Calc 2017B, refer to the complete release notes available on our website at www.thermocalc.com, where you can also find all of the videos mentioned in this video, as well as many more.